Hello everyone, my name is Shubrata Kumar. I'm founder and CEO of Bhalo Social Enterprises. Bhalo is a farm inputs marketplace offering farm inputs like seeds, fertilizers, chemicals, advisory and credit facility. I was working for Swiss Contact, and that's how in the development sector, and that's how I got introduced to the world of agriculture and financial services. And after working for Swiss Contact for about 8 years, I decided to give it a shot and started Bhalo in 2019. So we all do our groceries, and when we walk into our grocery outlet like Shopno or Meena Bazaar, we see, I mean, most of the good brands are available there. We know about which products we're going to buy. If we don't, we have so much of information at our fingertips. You can go to your mobile, you can search, and you can find ratings of different products, reviews of different products. If you are running out of money, you can use your credit card at the checkout. But that's not the case when it comes to buying farm inputs routine, like the seeds, fertilizers, chemicals, feed, et cetera, medicines, et cetera. So the farmers often do not find the products that they need at the outlet. They don't know what to buy. So they have to rely on the retailer for advice. And they often do not get the right advice because retailer do not have an incentive in selling the best product. They would often sell the product that gives them the maximum margin and also that comes with credit. And the farmer doesn't have a credit card, but they need it the most. To pay at the end of the harvest. So there are millions of farmers like Hamidul Islam, who is from Kurigram, and they cannot access or use high quality farming inputs because of unavailability, lack of know-how or reliable advisory, and higher cost of accessing credit facility. And this results in lower production income for farmers like Hamidul and lost opportunity for companies like ACI and Renata. We are here to solve it. We offer curated high quality farming inputs, reliable advice, service, and low cost credit and insurance facility, which guarantees higher production and income, and also increased sales for companies like ACI and Renata. We make money by earning a commission on sales of the inputs, and we charge additional fees for providing advisory and also offering extending credit facility. This is our simple business model. We connect high quality farm input suppliers and the farmers through logistics hubs and exclusive sales agents. So the exclusive sales agents are basically rural tech-savvy youth whom we hire and groom and deploy in the rural areas. They typically cover a few villages. And they are the ones who visit, promote, advise, sell, and also manage transactions with the farmers. At the back end, we have the logistics hubs, which basically works as a fulfillment center, fulfilling the orders generated by these agents. We initially started with an offline model. And after we perfected this, now we are moving into developing our tech stack. In the beginning, we are developing a micro ERP solution for the sales agents, and later on, we want to move to an online marketplace. So the front end, we have an application right now for the agents, and the back end, we have a web application for the logistics hub operation, as well as farm input companies and the financial institutions. At the moment, the front end is only for the agents, and in future, it would be farmers can also access it. So the application has a few modules. The sales and inventory management is the key part of it. And then we're going to have product and pricing management module, customer relationship module, advisory and farm productivity management, as well as on credit risk assessment and credit management module. Impact mandate, and by increasing farmers' production and also income, we are contributing to SDG 1, 2, and 3. By creating access for women for different products and services, because we are going door to door and providing services and products, we're contributing to SDG 5. And by creating opportunities for people like Ershadul, we are also contributing to a decent work and economic growth with our sales agent. Coming to the market size, there are 16 million farmers in Bangladesh, and considering a $500 annual spend per farmer, this represents a market opportunity of $8 billion. We are considering livestock inputs as well as also farming crop inputs. Our target is to take 5% serve 5% of the farmers and take 1% share by 2027, which is basically $80 million. Here are the other players. So in this Venn diagram, I have shown a kind of combination of inputs, tech-based advisory, and flexible finance. So when it comes to inputs, our main competition is basically the local retail outlets who are providing, selling different kinds of inputs. So they are our main competitors. And there is Syngenta, multinational. They operate franchise retail outlets. They run around 8,000 outlets in the rural areas. There are companies who operate at the intersection of inputs and advisory, like AgroStar, Big Heart, and Deha. These are all Indian companies, have gone to scale. And on the finance and input intersection, there are companies like Jai Kisan from India and Tarfin from Turkey, who provide financing for purchasing inputs at the point of sale. So these companies, all of these companies have gone to scale. In Bangladesh, we have iPage, who is providing tech-based advisory as well as also buyback from farmers. iFarmer is there, and iFarmer is focusing on flexible financing, for offering flexible financing to the farmers. So Bhalo is operating at the intersection of inputs, tech-based advisory, and flexible finance. And we want to continue to focus on that. Here is our team. So I started this. I have 10 plus years of experience in agriculture and financial services. And later on, I partnered up with Empower. And Mithun Bhai has more than 20 years of experience in technology business. We've already roped in the market leaders, especially in the input suppliers from in the livestock sector, ACI Godrej and Renata, all the leading players in the crop sector, like Metal, Petrochem, NAFCO, Auto Prop Care. We've also done some partnership with the BRAC Microfinance, as well as we are offering, we offered insurance facilities in partnership with Carnival Assure. I'm an Acumen Fellow, and we have been accelerated by YGAP, which is an Australian nonprofit supporting social enterprises. And recently I'm attending an Impact Accelerator program organized by UNDP Turkey. Here is our scale-up strategy. We're going to, from now onwards, we're going to target small as well as medium farmers who are engaged in livestock as well as in crop production. We are currently operating in north in Kurigram, but we're soon expanding to south in Chennaidaho or Magura district. And we're going to offer farm inputs on cash as well as on credit, along with incentives and loyalty schemes. We're going to strengthen our sales agency network as well as also set up our own retail outlets in strategic locations. We are also offering home delivery. We started offering home delivery to farmers. We are exploring partnership with financial service providers in collaboration with Shadin FinTech. We're going to offer off-balance sheet lending to farmers. We're also talking to some of the commercial banks and NBFIs, including BRAC Bank and Bank Asia. We're going to strengthen our tech capabilities by developing and deploying an e-commerce platform, call center capability, and also hiring key management staff, especially CTO, CFO, and CMO. We're asking for $300,000 and we plan to raise this money within Q3 2021. And we'll use the money for tech development, team and office, agent and outlet setup. And rest of the money we'll be using for working capital, because at the moment, I think we need to generate a lot more data to convince our financial service partners to extend us with the working capital. Thank you very much. And I look forward to answering your questions.